And there's a certain, you know, there's a certain number of people in the world who...
Luckily, I've never had to deal with that problem.
who are just looking for people with money, and they might be completely honest and well-intentioned people, but they're still modifying their behavior, you know, to be in the orbit of the people with the money.
Oh yeah.
You know, and you know, you see that sort of a dynamic play out all the time at like a country club.
Yep.
Where you've got people who are barely able to be members at a club, you know, they can barely afford it financially, but they have this ambition and they think, well, if I can just get my foot in that door and, you know, meet those people. And you see that play out all the time in real life, and it works. I mean, that can absolutely. Hell, you and I had a conversation. I recall this very clearly when, I don't know when this was, I'll say a year ago or maybe longer. And yep. You were talking about the idea of moving to New York, and we were just talking about the pros and cons of it. And you specifically mentioned, you know, a specific social club. I believe that James Altucher,
Soho House,
yeah. had I don't know if he turned you onto it or whatever.
Yeah, it was Bill and I. He took to the Soho House in Manhattan.
And you know, you said that it was a place where there were lots of people of influence, and you know, you were talking about that, you know, in an excited fashion. And there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I don't mean to say. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. It's just the same phenomenon that I'm talking about, which is, you know, you just wonder sometimes, like, is this person hanging out with me because they really like me or because they know I have all this money?